I had just started playing guitar, and I was kind of at the crossroads where I was finding everything that I loved about guitar had come from the blues in some way or another. All the rock, I mean, I grew up on the radio, so every guitar hero I was hearing on the radio, it was like they were influenced by blues music. And so I think that North Mississippi sort of bridged the gap for me between like rock and roll and this rough, raucous, raw sound. I really fell in love with it. I mean, and then further on down the rabbit hole, I started finding Delta Blues and like Skip James and Fred McDowell and, you know, Son House. And it just was like, it's a rabbit hole you fall into. And there's a deep well of musician, you know, music and tradition there. And it's just kind of colored everything I've done from here on out. But definitely the style of like trying to get my thumb and my fingers going at the same time. It's kind of like a hybrid picking, but there's no real... I don't know, I'm not doing it right, I guess. Like, there's not a technical, I'm not doing it technically the correct way, but it's just sort of what works for my hand. But that's kind of where I get that from, is trying to keep that bass going at the same time. It's like a melody up high. And when I did a couple records years ago, Luther Dickinson produced a couple of them, and he said, he kind of made this point about guitar playing and playing melodically, and if you can sing the line, then that's a good line, but if it's all this blah, 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 blah stuff, you know, it doesn't quite hit the same. So I took that to heart, and you know, that and this kind of style has really colored a lot for me.
Summer, babe, shaking them all down. Well, here we go. Now,
my dad's friends would all come over the house and play guitar when I was a kid, and they were all like bluegrass and country pickers. And I mean, I picked up a little bit of that singer-songwriter bug from them. And I mean, I can't pick as fast as they could ever. They're just impossible, but the technique is pretty amazing. And then I was a punk kid, and I'm like, I want to go rock and roll. I bought a drum set instead of guitar first. But like I said, I listened to the radio a lot, and one of my favorite bands was Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers, and that was probably because my parents listened to them a lot too. But American Girl was always like my anthem. I think it's every American girl's anthem. But I went crazy trying to figure out the guitar solo. Mike Campbell's one of the most, I mean, tasteful guitar players, I feel like, and has written some of the most iconic lines. And this song is full of like really cool riffs.
Well, she was an American girl, raised on promises. She couldn't help thinking that there was a little more to life somewhere else. After all, it was a great big world with lots of places to run to. Then if she had to die trying, she one little promise she was gonna keep. Oh yeah, all right, take it easy, baby. Make it last like last night. She was an American girl.
I always liked it because the B would go to this like. full of cool little riffs, but there's like a section in the middle that I was, that was fun. And then of course like the funky riffs on the way out. I was always trying to play like really fast, so it was like way before I had the dexterity to do. Yeah, Mike Campbell's a beast. Blues was always in the like in the background of everything that was being played, or you know, in the forefront even. But when I started picking up guitar and finding, you know, blues music in my life, one of the first cool songs I learned to take out to my show and to take out to jams. There's not really a specific riff that goes with it, but I played in a trio, and so a lot of times I'd teach myself like the piano riff, thinking that was, you know, it was definitely an integral part of the song, so adapting it for the trio. But I learned Freddie King's Same Old Blues, and that was cool for me. That was an aha moment, because I figured out how to play between the D and the B, you know, major and minor, and how to change up my solos to, you know, like you're playing a D and you got this really happy, pretty solo going on, and then you can blues it up. And then just kind of jumping between those two, you know, those two chords was really fun, you know, those two scales. So.
Morning rain keeps on falling like the tears, they fall from my eyes as I sit in my room staring out at the gloom. Oh, it's the rain. It's the same old blues.
Yeah.
I can't help but thinking, baby, when the sun used to shine on my back door, now the sun's turned to rain. All my laughter has turned to pain. Oh, it's the rain. It's the same old blues
now. was a punk-ass little kid for a long time. Still am. And I loved Black Sabbath. So my life had five riffs. I would not be right if I wasn't including this next song, so. Trying to make Black Sabbath into a blues band in my mind. They definitely are. That's what they started as. But, you know, just this is another song that I sat down and, like, worked it out from top to bottom.
Generals gathered in their masses, just like witches at black masses. Evil minds that plot destruction, sorcerers of disconstruction. Well, in the fuse of bodies burning, as the war machine keeps churning. Death and hatred to mankind, poisoning the brainwashed minds. Oh Lord, yeah.
Awesome for me. I loved all kinds of stuff like that. I mean, like I said, I listened to the radio, like Alice Cooper and AC/DC and Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers, Rolling Stones, Keith Richards was one of my favorite guitar players. And they all brought me to blues music. The last riff though is kind of going back to the North Mississippi thing again. Arl Burnside being one of my favorites. He had the song called Goin' Down South, which sort of employed all the things I like about finger picking and stuff. You know? And it's a song with a groove, like it's just a riff all the way through. And I do love the riff. So.
I don't care where you go.
My life of five. No. So that's kind of, I don't know, to me that's, that groove thing was really important to me in my musical upbringing, like keeping that groove going through the whole song. And I've done some solo shows, so like having the ability to be able to keep the song going, just, you know, and without the whole band, is something that kind of music really instilled in me, so.